So preparation of dihydrogen. So laboratory methods any from acids, any active metal reacts with dilute mineral acids that liberates hydrogen gas. So active metals are nothing but 1A, 2A metals along with zinc. Let us take an example. That is, our zinc reacts with dilute H2SO4 gives ZnSO4 plus hydrogen gas. Previously, I wrote this one as nascent hydrogens. If there is no nascent hydrogen combined with each other automatically, if there is no further reaction, that converts into hydrogen gas. Any, it is a synthesis of, it is the preparation of hydrogen in laboratory. Any, preparation of hydrogen. Please balance it, boys. Next. Sodium metal. And sodium metal reacts with dilute HCl that gives NaCl plus hydrogen gas, half H2. So this is the way to prepare hydrogen in laboratory. Any. So that is from acids. So when active metals, zinc, sodium is 1A group element. So 2A metals and 1A, 2A metals are zinc and these are active metals. So see boys, that is copper, silver, gold, platinum, mercury, these are not active. So not produce hydrogen gas. Because these are not active. Activeness ఏంటి అదంతా కూడా మన డిస్కషన్ ఎక్కడ డిస్కస్ చేయొచ్చు అంటే సో ఎలక్ట్రోకెమిస్ట్రీ లో ఈ నాట్ వాల్యూస్ బేస్ చేసుకుని చెప్తామని లేటర్ దట్ ఇస్ 1A గ్రూప్ లోకి వెళ్ళినప్పుడు డిస్కస్ చేద్దాం 1A మెటల్స్ నెక్స్ట్ ఫ్రమ్ బేసిస్ సెకండ్ ప్రిపరేషన్ మెథడ్ from acids, from bases, these are laboratory preparation methods. Now bases, what are those? When zinc or aluminium reacts with a base, strong base, that gives hydrogen gas, zinc or aluminium, only these are the elements, very very important boys. So see here, zinc reacts with NaOH, strong base, that gives Na2 ZnO2 plus H2O. So balance it, boys. 2NaOH. Na2 ZnO2. So that is H2 gas. This is sodium zincate. Sodium zincate is the compound. So along that, hydrogen gas is liberated. Next, aluminium. Al plus 3NaOH. This combination gives Na3AlO3 plus H2O. So for our balancing, 3/2 H2O. So this is called as sodium aluminate. So sodium aluminate, along that hydrogen gas is liberated. Next, at the same time, boys, these reactions are very, very, very important. Number of times. So fill in the blanks. So what is A? Now, same aluminium reacts with NaOH in place of water, that is aqueous NaOH. Aqueous NaOH is used. So that gives NaAlO2 plus hydrogen. This is called as sodium meta-aluminate. Sodium meta-aluminate, along that hydrogen gas, for our convenience. So hydrogen, that is 3/2 H2. So this is the way to prepare. So hydrogen gas in from bases. It is aqueous base. So when zinc or aluminium reacts with NaOH like strong bases, so those liberates hydrogen gases. So all these are laboratory preparation methods. Now, industrially, how hydrogen gas is prepared? That is large scale preparations. See boys, that is సింథసిస్ అండి హైడ్రోజన్. దట్ ఈస్ లార్జ్ స్కేల్ ప్రిపరేషన్ ఆఫ్ హైడ్రోజన్, లార్జ్ స్కేల్ ప్రిపరేషన్ ఆఫ్ హైడ్రోజన్. సో దట్ ఈస్ ఫ్రమ్ ఫస్ట్ వన్ రా ఎలక్ట్రాలసిస్ టెక్నిక్ అండి. ఎలక్ట్రాలసిస్ టెక్నిక్ ఇన్ పర్టికులర్ ఎలక్ట్రాలసిస్ ఆఫ్ ఎసిడిఫైడ్ వాటర్ ఆర్ ఆల్కలైన్ వాటర్ అండి. దట్ మీన్స్ ఎలక్ట్రాలసిస్ ఆఫ్ వాటర్ బాయ్స్, ఎలక్ట్రాలసిస్ ఆఫ్ వాటర్. ఐ థింక్ ఇన్ యువర్ సెవెంత్ క్లాస్ ఆర్ సిక్స్త్ క్లాస్ ఎలక్ట్రాలసిస్ ఆఫ్ వాటర్ యూ లర్న్ ఇట్. యు లర్న్ సి హియర్ దిస్ ఇస్ ద డయాగ్రామ్. సో దిస్ ఈస్ లైక్ దిస్, దెర్ ఈస్ ఎ డయాగ్రామ్. సో ఫ్రమ్ ద బాటమ్ టూ ప్లాటినం రాడ్స్ ఆర్ దేర్. సో టెస్ట్ ట్యూబ్స్ ఆర్ ప్లేస్డ్, టెస్ట్ ట్యూబ్స్. సో దిస్ ఈస్ కరెంట్ ఈస్ పాస్డ్, కరెంట్ ఈస్ పాస్డ్. దిస్ ఈస్ ఆల్ వాటర్ అండి. ఇన్ వన్ కండిషన్ హైడ్రోజన్ గ్యాస్ అండ్ అదర్ వన్ ఈస్ ఆక్సిజన్ గ్యాస్ ఆర్ లిబరేటెడ్. సో దిస్ ఈస్ ఆల్రెడీ ఇన్ యువర్ టెన్త్ క్లాస్, not 10th class, it is maybe 6th or 7th class. Electrolysis of water. Pure water is bad conductor of electricity. For that purpose, to this, either little acid or base is added. So that is impure by adding that little HCl or base. So if acid is added, that is called as acidulated water. If base is added, that is alkaline water. So whatever it may be, there is an impurity. So automatically the conductivity of pure water increases. Through that, current is passed automatically. Hydrogen and oxygen. Yes. So hydrogen and oxygen will be liberated at anode and cathode. So which one and where it is formed. See here, I am taking alkaline water. So that means some base is added. So here, during this electrolyte, through this current is passed. What is that electrolyte? The electrolyte usually is acidified water or alkaline water. So I am taking alkaline water, boys. I am taking for explanation alkaline water. I am taking that is electrolyte. Through that current is passed. Now electrodes end for passes of current. Platinum rods. Both anode and cathode, platinum rods are used for passes of current. Platinum rods. Okay. Now at anode, oxidation takes place. At cathode, reduction takes place. At anode, always oxidation. At cathode, always reduction. So oxidation means loss of electrons. Reduction means gain of electrons. See here. So at anode, so 2OH- that is added, that is base end. 2OH- gives half O2 by the evolution of 2 electrons plus H2O. Half O2 plus 2 electrons. That means electrons are released, boys. That is why it is oxidation. Next, at cathode, reduction takes place. Gain of electrons. That is 2H2O, water involved in the reaction. Takes the two electrons and liberates hydrogen gas and 2OH-. So this is at anode, this is at cathode. Here, gain of electrons, reduction. Here, loss of electrons, oxidation. Now, net reaction. Therefore, net reaction means addition of these two equations. Electrons cancel. 2OH cancel. 2H2O, one water molecule cancel. Now the final reaction is H2O gives H2 plus off. Here hydrogen gas at cathode hydrogen gas is liberated. At anode oxygen gas is liberated. This is the way to prepare hydrogen by the electrolysis of acidified water or alkaline water. So this is hydrogen. Hydrogen is liberated at cathode. See, boys, in this reaction, how many moles of electrons transferred from anode to cathode? Anode loses 2 electrons, cathode gains 2 electrons. That means 2 moles of electrons are transferred 2 moles of electrons transferred for 1 mole water molecule involved in the reaction. Therefore, for 1 mole water, 2 mole electrons are involved. 2 moles electrons means 2 Faraday current is used. 2 Faraday charge, not current. Charge is used for production of this hydrogen. That is 2 Faraday means 2 into 96,500 coulombs charge is used. 2 into 96,500 coulombs charge is used. These points are also important, boys. For 1 mole water involving reaction, 2 moles electrons, 2 Faraday, 2 into 96,500 coulombs charge is involved. So for the passage of current, that is very, very important. That is a required charge end. For the required charge, my dear boys. Okay, so this is electrolysis of acidified water. In this way, industrially, hydrogen is generated and hydrogen is prepared. Next preparation method. Next preparation method, that is from coke end. It is also very, very important. Second industrial method, from coke. From coke, this reaction is called as coal gasification. Name is important. Coal gasification reaction for the synthesis of hydrogen. What is coke? How this one is? See, boys, here carbon, that is nothing but coke end. That is red hot coke, you should use it. Red hot coke end. Red, very, very red hot coke end. Through this red hot coke, water wave, that is a steam end, hot steam is passed end. Through red hot coke, hot steam is passed at about 1000 degrees centigrade. At about 1000 degrees centigrade, a steam is passed through red hot coke. Automatically, it gives carbon monoxide and hydrogen gas. Carbon monoxide and hydrogen gas. Here, delta H for this reaction is plus 121.5 kilojoules. Plus 121.5 kilojoules. Boys, it is a plus. Plus means endothermic reaction. Endothermic reaction. In this process, carbon monoxide gas and hydrogen gas mixture is formed, not individual. The carbon monoxide plus hydrogen gas mixture is called as, that is water gas, which is called as water gas. Which is called as water gas. Here, both carbon monoxide and hydrogen. But we want only hydrogen. So this synthesis of water gas from this equation is called as coal gasification. So it is hydrogen. To increase the percentage of hydrogen, so the formed CO is once again treated with steam end. The formed CO once again treated with steam end. This gives, or there is kind of carbon monoxide change to carbon dioxide. Once again, hydrogen gas is liberated. That means the percentage of hydrogen is increased. The percentage of hydrogen is increased. So, in the presence of a catalyst, iron chromate, FeCrO4, this iron chromate, very, very important, which acts as a catalyst. So, in presence of iron chromate catalyst, so the percentage of hydrogen is increased. This reaction is called as water gas shift reaction. That means to increase the percentage of hydrogen, the formed CO is once again treated with steam, which is also gas, boys. So percentage of hydrogen is increased. Water gas shift reaction. What is the catalyst used here? FeCrO4, that is iron chromate. Iron chromate at about 673 Kelvin. At about 673 Kelvin, iron chromate acts as a catalyst. Iron chromate acts as a catalyst. See, boys, the important product here is CO plus H2O. CO plus H2O. That is very, very important. Industrial use is there. This is called as water gas. When this gas, this mixture is going to be burned, it is burned in blue color. That is why this water gas is also called as a blue gas. This water gas is also called as blue gas. Next, that water gas is used for the synthesis of number of organic compounds, number of different variety of compounds. For the synthesis of number of compounds, that's why that gas is called as synthesis gas. That is also called as synthesis gas, or in short, which is called as a syngas. Syngas or synthesis gas, both these are same. So water gas is also called as blue gas, syngas. Why it is called as syngas? For the preparation of more number of different products and different compounds, for the synthesis of more number of compounds. So later we will explain the concepts. So that is the water gas. Any, so to enrich the hydrogen percentage, automatically the formed CO once again treated with hot steam. So that reaction is called as water gas shift reaction. Here iron chromate is the catalyst. Next. Now, see boys, in this reaction, coal gasification important, water gas, which of the following is coal gasification, which of the following is water gas shift reaction? Please try to identify boys. So today, this syngas, this synthesis gas may also produce in different number of ways, and not only in this way. So different number of ways are there. So nowadays, syngas also prepared from first one, that is water, sewage water. Yes, just a minute. Sewage water, that is our drainage water, that is also used for the synthesis of syngas. Drainage water. Next, second one. That is sawdust. That means sawmills are there. Yes. Okay. Sewage water, sawdust. That means so wood cutting time lo dust ostundi. That dust is called as sawdust. Next, that is used. Third one, scraps. Yes. Scrap wood and jeptan. Scrap wood is also used for the synthesis of that syngas. These are the raw materials. And also our waste newspapers. Newspapers also used for the synthesis of this syngas, because this is that much important. So this is very, very important, boys. Okay. So these are the different ways to prepare hydrogen gas. So that is mostly electrolysis. Purest form of hydrogen will be there. Next, also from coal gas. So different methods are there. So in our nature, hydrogen is the most important source of energy, any no doubt. Okay. So nowadays, the required percentage, that means more amount of hydrogen is required. Among the requirements, almost 77% hydrogen is coming out from petrochemicals. Petrochemicals, see here, what is that reaction? Third one, petrochemicals. Okay, that is steam reacts with hydrocarbons. These hydrocarbons from petroleum products. Hydrocarbons or coke at high temperature gives hydrogen gas in the presence of catalyst. So this is called as preparation of hydrogen from hydrocarbons. See here, I am taking example CnH2n+2. It is nothing but alkanes. Any alkane, whatever it may be, it reacts with steam. Nothing but n moles water vapor in the presence of nickel catalyst at about nearly 1000 degrees centigrade. Nearly 1000 degrees centigrade, that gives n moles carbon monoxide plus 2n plus 1 moles hydrogen gas will be liberated. 2n plus 1 moles hydrogen gas will be liberated. Okay, so this is the way to prepare hydrogen gas and hydrogen gas. So this is from petroleum. See, boys. So presently, so among required hydrogen, so almost 77% from petrochemicals, it is from hydrogen, required hydrogen from almost 77% from petrochemicals. Next 18% from coal. Next 4% from electrolysis of aqueous solutions, electrolysis of aqueous solutions, and remaining 1% other methods. So at one time the percentages are asked in your exam wise. Okay, 77% from petrochemicals. So from coal, 18% required amount required. So there is 4% from electrolysis of solution, aqueous solution, 1% from other solutions. So this is presently hydrogen. The preparation is takes place. Okay, so number of reactions, sir. Not only this, any that is alkanes may be generally used. And okay, this is the synthesis of hydrogen, boys. This is here coal gasification, water gasship reaction, very, very important. Next, properties of this hydrogen, physical properties and chemical properties. Properties of hydrogen, that is, physical properties of hydrogen. See, boys, the prepared hydrogen is a colorless gas, colorless, odorless, that is tasteless gas, and it is the lightest gas. It is the lightest gas, almost not soluble in water. Almost not soluble in water. Very, very important. Hydrogen is insoluble in water, boys. Insoluble in water. Next, boys, here very, very important. It undergoes adsorption on palladium metal, adsorption on palladium metal, which is called as occlusion. And occlusion, what is this occlusion? That is adsorption of hydrogen gas on palladium metal surface. What is adsorption? Adsorption is nothing but a metal surface is there, boys. This is metal surface. Let us take palladium. So on this metal surface, hydrogen gas is attracted only on the surface, not entered into the interior part, not entered into the bulk part. Okay, so only on the surface of our metal end. This adsorption of hydrogen gas on palladium metal surface is commonly called as occlusion or occlusion, whatever it may be. Okay, that means palladium metal surface is the good source of hydrogen. Good source of hydrogen. So this is very, very important, boys. So occlusion of hydrogen on palladium metal surface. So palladium surface is the best source for hydrogen. Adsorption means only on the surface, not entered into the bulk. Not entered into the bulk. That is called as adsorption. Okay. So this hydrogen is highly inflammable, boys. No doubt. But the transportation, hydrogen is transported from one to another. That is by using CaH2, in the form of CaH2, that is called as hydrolith. So that means hydrogen is converted into CaH2. Occlusion means the property is called as occlusion, boys. That's number CaH2. So hydrolith. So that is hydrogen transportation along with in the form of CaH2. If that's later, tomorrow I will discuss it. These are some physical properties, boys. Some physical properties. Now, chemical properties. Chemical properties. Chemical properties of hydrogen. See here, hydrogen. There is a bond between hydrogen and hydrogen. A single bond. This hydrogen molecule is formed by the combination of 1s orbital of one hydrogen, second hydrogen, 1s orbital by mutual overlapping. It is a sigma SS over 1s, 1s overlap. Sigma 1s, 1s is the strongest bond among all bonds. Among all bonds. That means, the hydrogen-hydrogen bond is very, very strong bond. So that means the energy required to break this, because when it is involved in the reaction, first of all, that molecule converts into atoms. And otherwise, reaction is not possible. That means there should be a bond breaking requirement is there. That is right. So that is how much energy is required. Almost 435.9 kilojoules of energy per mole is required. That is a very high amount, boys. That is why hydrogen not easy to break. That is why at ordinary temperatures, hydrogen is the less reactive. Hydrogen, because of high bond dissociation energy. At ordinary conditions, less reactive. But at elevated temperatures, as temperature increases, its reactivity increases. Its reactivity increases. Now, so hydrogen reactions mostly at elevated temperatures takes place in, mostly. So now what are the reactions available here? So first of all, reaction with air. So, reaction with air. So, in air, nitrogen and oxygen are available. So, at ordinary conditions, so our hydrogen reacts with oxygen. Oxygen that gives H2O. That gives H2O. So, at ordinary room temperature condition, at ordinary room, 2H2O plus that is 2H2O. So, particularly, this oxygen from air involved in the reaction. Next, at nitrogen, elevated temperature reaction takes place. So, not at here. Second one, with halogens, very, very important, boys. Our hydrogen reacts with halogens. What are those halogens? So, see here. With halogens, that is our hydrogen reacts with chlorine, bromine, and iodine. Chlorine, bromine, iodine. These are the halogens. Our hydrogen reacts with any. So if these two are react with each other, that gives 2HF. These two, that is 2HCl. These two, 2HBr. These two gives 2HIn. 2HIr. So this is the reactive boy. See, hydrogen reaction with fluorine is a vigorous reaction, instantaneous reaction, very fast reaction, rapid reaction. Rapid reaction, very fast. That means whenever hydrogen is in contact with fluorine, automatically reaction takes place. That means huge attraction between those two is available. So it is the best example for instantaneous reactions, fast reactions. So this takes place, so in the presence of light or dark, in both cases, the reaction takes place. In the presence of light or dark, both reaction takes place. But hydrogen reacts with chlorine only possible in the presence of light. That means the reactivity of hydrogen with chlorine only takes place in the presence of light. So if no light is there, no reaction is there. That is why the formation of HCl from hydrogen and chlorine is called as a photochemical reaction. In the presence of sunlight, only the reaction takes place. Photochemical reactions. Next, reaction of hydrogen with bromine. Something decreases running. So for this purpose, heating is required. Some heat energy is also required. That is why it is after heating reaction takes place, it is thermochemical reaction. thermochemical reaction, reaction of hydrogen with brominate. Next, reaction of hydrogen with iodine, almost not possible boys, it require heating and catalyst. So both heating and catalyst, heating and catalyst platinum, both are possible. So otherwise a backward reaction also possible. So that means in the presence of catalyst, the reaction takes place. It is a catalytic reaction. It is a catalytic reaction. This is the way when hydrogen reacts with halogen possible. Tell me boys, what about the reactivity of hydrogen with these halogens from top to bottom? What about, is this increased or decreased reactivity of this hydrogen with halogens? Reactivity of hydrogen with halogens from top to bottom increases or decreases? Yes, decreases. Top to bottom, hydrogen reactivity decreases with the halogens, only in particular halogens. So this is what we observed. Rapid reaction, very fast reaction, photochemical reaction, thermochemical reaction, catalytic reactions, catalytic reaction. Next, with other elements, not only halogens, other non-metals like nitrogen, that is nitrogen with reaction. So N2 plus 3H2Ra reversible with 2NH3. What is this reaction? It is a synthesis of ammonia by Haber's process. For this purpose, according to your Lee-Chatelier principle, so what we required, that is high pressure, which is almost 200 atmospheres pressure from your Lee-Chatelier principle. Low temperature, almost 450 to 500 degrees centigrade, because elevated temperature is required. And catalyst, that is iron molybdenum mixture acts as a catalyst. Iron is catalyst, molybdenum is promoter. So all these are applied. So for the reaction of hydrogen with nitrogen, for the synthesis of ammonia, that is by Haber's process. That means hydrogen is used for the synthesis of most of the chemicals, important chemicals, ammonia. That is ammonia is the most important raw material for the synthesis of urea. That is most important, that is most required. That is best. Urea is the fertilizer that is required by us for us. Okay, so that is ammonia. So that means hydrogen reacts with nitrogen, that gives ammonia. Next, and also most important reaction boys, that is our hydrogen acts as a reducing agent. Our hydrogen H2 acts as a reducing agent. In metallurgy, metal extractions. In metallurgy, hydrogen acts as a reducing agent. See here. So examples for that one. For example, molybdenum, MOO3, molybdenum oxide, when reacts with hydrogen, gives molybdenum plus H2O. Balance this equation. So that means the metal is extracted. Tungsten, tungsten oxide reacts with hydrogen, W plus H2O. Tungsten metal is collected. That means oxygen is removed with the help of hydrogen. Removal of oxygen from the material is called as reduction. That is with the help of hydrogen. Therefore, hydrogen acts as a reducing agent. Next, again, CuO reacts with hydrogen, gives Cu plus H2O. Copper metal is reduced. At the same time, silver chloride on silver end. That is H2O that gives Ag plus 2HCl. This is the way hydrogen acts as a reducing agent in the extraction of some metals. Okay. So this is hydrogen. Next, hydrogen is used as a, that is used in Dalda making. That is unsaturated oils are changed to saturated oils. Unsaturated compounds are changed to saturated compounds. Right? That is called as hydrogenation. That is hydrogenation of oils. That is unsaturated hydrocarbons. When reacts with hydrogen in the presence of rani nickel. So converts into saturated hydrocarbons. Unsaturated hydrocarbons converts into saturated hydrocarbons in the presence of Raney Nicolin. That is CnH2n. That is simply I am taking an example. R CH double bond CH R dash reacts with hydrogen in the presence of nickel. It is unsaturated hydrocarbon, boys. Converts into R CH single bond CH. H and H are added. It is addition reaction. And R dash, it is unsaturated hydrocarbon. Change it to saturated hydrocarbon. It is nothing but oil and it is nothing but Dalda and fat part and fat and the Dalda making end. So there, Raney Nicolin acts as good catalyst end. Here, hydrogen is applied end. This process is called as hydrogenation of oils. There, hydrogen is used as a reagent end for making Dalda-like chemicals end, the Dalda-like materials. Okay. Next, hydrogen is also used for making ethyl alcohol. See here, these are all some applications, some uses of hydrogen end. Chemical properties along with uses end. See here, that is. H2 hydrogen plus CO plus H2, it is a water gas and hydrogen reacts with water gas that produce CH3OH and which is methyl alcohol. It is used for the making methyl alcohol, and the most important here is ZnO plus CrO3 and CR2O3. ZnO plus CR2O3. This one acts as catalyst. Very, very important. In the synthesis of methyl alcohol from water gas, the catalyst used is ZnO plus chromic oxide. ZnO plus chromic oxide is the catalyst. Or when carbon monoxide reacts with two hydrogens, here cobalt acts as catalyst. Here also methyl alcohol is formed. So here water gas is used. Here carbon monoxide with hydrogen. Both reactions are similar, but here this is the catalyst. Here this is the catalyst. Cobalt is the catalyst. This is the synthesis of methyl alcohol, boys, from water gas with the help of hydrogen. Next, and also very, very important reaction, that is almost last reaction, boys. That is carbon monoxide. N moles carbon monoxide reacts with 2N moles hydrogen. 2N moles hydrogen in the presence of Fe2O3 plus cobalt. These are the catalysts. Fe2O3 cobalt that gives CnH2n plus water and it is alkene. Next, at the same time, N moles carbon monoxide reacts with 2N plus 1 mole hydrogen that gives same Fe2O3 plus cobalt. So CnH2n plus 2. CnH2n plus 2, it is alkane plus H2O. So this is alkanes, boys. These are alkenes. So this is the good composition of petroleum, which is called as synthetic petroleum. This combination is called as synthetic petrol. So preparation of synthetic petrol is with the help of hydrogen cell. Here Fe2O3 and cobalt are used. So here Fe2O3, what is the purpose of this Fe2O3? Fe2O3 is used to remove sulfur impurities present in these chemicals. To remove sulfur impurities, Fe2O3 is used. Cobalt acts as a catalyst. Cobalt acts as a catalyst. So this is the preparation method of synthetic petroleum. This reaction is called as, this is called as Fischer-Tropsch process. So that is, which is called as FISCHER, Fischer, PRO, PSCH, Fischer-Tropsch process, which is nothing but preparation of synthetic petrol. Very, very important, boys. Very, very important. Okay. So these are some properties and also uses of this hydrogen. And also hydrogen is used as a fuel cell and used in fuel cells. So tomorrow we will discuss. Thank you, boys.